Hey guys, Whipchip here with a review of the LEGO Ninjago City Gardens. Ninjago City has got to be one of my favorite LEGO sets of all time, so it comes as no surprise that this is now one of my favorite LEGO sets of all time. I love this set. This set also comes with an amazing minifigure selection of 22 minifigures. It also has over 5,000 pieces, making it my biggest LEGO set at the time. But yeah, let's get in with those minifigures. Alright, so if we want to get to Ninjago City, we're going to have to fly through these minifigures. But first, I love this Sensei Wu. He is exclusive to this set, and he looks amazing. He has a really cool gold beard, as well as a gold face print of what his Seasonal 11 design looks like. I guess also same with 13 and 12. But he has an exclusive torso, which doesn't appear to be used for Zane as I first thought. He also has the same legs as everyone, which look really nice, as well as a gold staff, as well as that really cool logo of the 10 Ninjago years. Kind of funny though that this is my first Ninjago golden minifigure, and it is the one that comes in the biggest set. Next up, we have Young Lloyd. Now, I really like the design of this guy. He uses his March of the Oni torso, which is really nice because he only comes in a select few sets with that legacy design, even though he was the main character in March of the Oni. So it's nice to get more of him. And he also has that face, which was exclusive to the Destiny's Bounty. Now, I was able to get that off of Bricks and Pieces, so it's not like it's very desirable for me right now, but it's still pretty cool to get more of. But, of course, the best part is that hair piece. This hair was always wanted from fans from all ages, especially when the original seasons of Ninjago came out, so it's so nice that we finally get it, because this is the first time it's actually ever been molded in this color. Yeah, that's so nice of the Ninjago crew to give it to us. Next up, we have Legacy Kai. Now, odds are that you've already seen a ton of reviews of this minifigure, so I'll keep it brief. I really like his dual-molded headpiece, I guess, as well as his head print, which is from the LEGO Ninjago movie. It's also, his torso and legs are from March of the Oni, which are pretty nice to get. He also has that gold scabbard, which comes in Lloyd's golden mech, as well as the Destiny's Bounty, so it's really nice to get it here. I also just like having some ninja in the set, because you can have them, like, you know, flipping around, stopping, say, the mechanic and his henchmen, so that's pretty nice that we at least get a couple of ninja. Next up, we have Zane. So something really awesome about this minifigure is that they chose, instead of giving us that really creepy Ninjago movie face, to give us this really cool silver metal face, which Zane has in almost every set nowadays. So that's just super nice of the crew to give it to us in the big Ninjago celebrating Ninjago set, instead of giving us that stupid Ninjago movie one. But yeah, he again, same sort of situation as Kai. I'm gonna guess you've seen a lot of him, so I'll keep it brief, but I really like this minifigure. Next up, we have Casual Cole, which is kind of funny because we've already gotten three. This will be our third Casual Cole, which I find kind of funny. He uses the same pants as the Hidden Side Construction Workers pants, which I think is pretty cool. He has the Prime Empire game controller, which I really like, as well as this torso, which I just got off of Bricks and Pieces, so it's kind of funny to see it right here. And it fits Cole pretty well. It's also, again, just really nice to get his hair in more sets. I do like getting Cole's hair. And you can see just his alternate face. Next, we have Jay. Casual Jay, that is. Again, this is our second version of a Casual Jay from the Ninjago movie series. Was our first. I really like this one, however, because it looks just like the one in the show. But he has these little pins on the side of his torso, which were also in his Season 11 outfit, which I think is really fitting. He also has a flower for Nia, and then it's just really nice to get that hairpiece, because again, it really doesn't come in that many sets. That's pretty nice to get. Next, we have Nia, who looks to be overjoyed that Jay has taken her on a date, which I think is pretty cute. She uses the same design jacket, or denim jacket, as the jacket she had in the Ninjago movie sets, which is really cool, because she also had this design in Season 8, Episode 1, which I really like. Again, it's just nice to get a Nia with her hair. Even though that hairpiece did come in the Gamers Market, it's still pretty cool to get, because we never actually got her in a kendo pod, but she did come in the Ninjago movie CMF series with that hair. But still, I didn't get that minifigure, so it's really nice to get it right here. Then, there is Misako. So Misako actually only comes in one other set, even though she is in almost every season of Ninjago. And that set is the Temple of Air Jitsu. Now, I don't own that set. Well, not the real one anyway. And it's sort of disappointing, though, to get her in this set without her actual torso. It's sort of frustrating for a fan like me, because it's like, yay, now I get a Misako that never appeared in the show. Now, if they did change her design, I'd be fine with it, but judging by the new Season 14 trailer, they haven't changed it yet. That's pretty disappointing. But that is an exclusive printing for her torso, But she also has an exclusive, she has a face, and that face actually comes in a couple Winter Village sets, so I have it already. You can see she's got like a happy face, and then an even happier face, which is really nice, as well as her hair. It would have been really cool to get that hair with that white streak in the back, like she does have in the show, but I understand why they couldn't do that. It would have been it would have cost too much money, and I would rather have not the streak in the hair and have gotten more minifigures. Then there's Clutch Powers, who also comes in the minifigure pack. Now, this minifigure is technically inaccurate to the show, because not of the little sash, but that there's no leg printing. In the belt in the show, there is also a belt on his little waist print. So it's sort of weird just to see him blank, but I do like that handbag. This minifigure also came in the little accessory pack, so it's really nice to get it here. It's also just fun to see Lloyd's old hair, as well as just to see Clutch Powers. I love the original Clutch Powers movie. So it's really cool that they brought him back for the show, even if he was sort of, you know, disappointing. I still would rather have him than not have him at all. Next, we have the Mechanic. So the Mechanic is really interesting because of his ginormous weapon. I love that thing. Now, this Mechanic is very underwhelming to me because I made my own Mechanic, which I'll hopefully be doing a video about soon, and they didn't mold his little, like, eye thing, which is ridiculous to me. But taking off his bowler hat, you can just sort of see his print for his face. Now, it is pretty nice, though, that we at least got a Mechanic, but still. I do like his torso, though. That's a really good torso, even if his arm has no printing on it whatsoever, even when it should. And then he's got dual-molded legs, which, again, it's really frustrating because his jacket in the show obviously carries down into the legs, so it sort of just looks lazy. But still, again, I'd rather get one Mechanic than no Mechanic. Now, I don't want to turn this into a rant about the minifigures, but this minifigure I do have a problem with, and that is that she is feminine. And now, that sounds really sexist, but hear me out. In the show, every single one of the Mechanic's henchmen was male, so why is there a female henchman? I don't get it. But, putting that aside, I actually really like this minifigure. I love her face, because we don't actually get many female robber faces, so it's really nice to get them. And you can see I love that face, because I love the thick eyebrows. I use that in my Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer advent calendar. You can also see I love her torso printing, as well as leg printing. She also has a diamond, and then this dual-molded hair hat combo, which I really like. Next up is a Ninjago fan. I really like her torso, which does come in a couple of sets nowadays. It's got Lloyd season 11 design, as well as the Lloyd on the back. She has this really cool hairpiece, which I think is the blonde, which is Black Widow's, as well as this really cool face where she's just happy and then winking. I like that a lot. We have this girl that sort of looks like a karate instructor, but she's not. There's no dojo in this set, which is sort of weird to me, but she has this really cool torso printing, which is Okino's from Prime Empire, as well as these legs, which I don't think I've ever actually seen these legs before. Maybe they're on that book exclusive Woo? I don't know. She also uses Jack's mom's face, Jack David's from Hidden Side, which I don't think works whatsoever on this minifigure. This is, again, sort of one of those minifigures I don't really like because of the face, because it just looks just like Jack's mom from Hidden Side. I don't know. Most people won't know that, but that's just something I noticed. Next up, we have Ronin. Now, I really like this design of Ronin because this is exactly what a legacy Ronin should look like. He's got a lot more detail than the first one, but it looks just like his first one, so it works really well. He uses Vaughn's little scarf attachment, which works really well, as well as his half mask. Now, his face underneath is kind of hard to see without removing his entire expression, but you can just sort of see he's happy. Next up is Hay. I really like this minifigure's design. He has an exclusive torso with the ice cream planet logo's design on it, which is really nice. He also has this ice cream cone with a dog poop piece, which I actually think works really well for ice cream, as well as the police commissioner from LEGO City Adventures face, and I think that works really well. All right, back to the rant. So this guy's face, again, ruins this minifigure for me. That is Young Woo's face print. That should not be on a citizen in Ninjago City. It can work in Monkey Kid, but it cannot work in Ninjago City. It also is kind of funny because he does use also Klaus's hair, so this guy's just stealing every Ninjago character's piece. However, if I didn't watch the TV show or if, like, I didn't know what Young Woo was, this guy looks definitely like he'd fit in Ninjago City. So I guess there's that. I do like his torso, too, because I don't own that torso. He also has a briefcase, as well as this phone print, which the only other set that comes in is the Spring Lantern Garden Festival. Then we have this girl. I really like her design. She uses this nice pink shirt, as well as this princess hair piece. She also has a pretzel, which is a pretty cool accessory to get. And then this face, which I don't actually own this face yet, so it's pretty cool to get it, but it is only one-sided, and mine's sort of stamped kind of blurry-ish, so I don't know. But I do like this minifigure
a lot. Then there's the last minifigure of the set, or I guess the last living minifigure of the set, which is Tito. I love Tito. He's great. He's got this really cool blue hat, this nice freckled face, as well as this really cool design for his shirt, his jacket. That only comes in a couple of sets, so it's really cool to get, as well as this VHS tape. Is that the Prime Empire motherboard? I don't know. Next, we have the Statue of Zane, which uses an unprinted head, torso, and legs to create that really cool statue design. Now, his armor is actually the Praetorian Guard's armor in silver, and I'm not actually sure how I feel about that armor because, you know, the actual Zane from the show didn't use it, but I like it also at the same time because they don't have that giant ring in the back. So it works pretty well. However, what doesn't work well is that he's not using his half mask. That half mask has never been molded in silver, so it's not like we can fill it in for them. So it sort of just feels like an incomplete Zane. He also has his new hair in silver, which is pretty cool to get because I don't own it yet. But at the same time, it's inaccurate to the scene. But contradicting that, it sort of looks extremely similar to his old hair, so I can sort of give him a pass. Now, comparing this to the version of the Zane statue that I made, you can just sort of see the differences. I think mine, of course, is better, but I think that just has to do with the armor as well as the hair. And then I also added the sword, because he had a sword in the show, as well as his falcon on the back, just to sort of look like the falcon landed on him. I really like that. Then we have Master Chen. Now, this is not actually how minifigures are meant to be assembled, but is how they show him being assembled, because the way they clip him onto his sign is using those legs like that. I love his torso design, which is exclusive, as well as his face, which is also exclusive. I love this minifigure so much, even though I really dislike Tournament of Elements. Now, here is the last minifigure of this set, which is Jay's Legacy costume. This is super cool to get. I did not know that this came in the set, so I was really excited to see it. He has this bright green head underneath it, so it sort of makes it, again, look like it's, you know, fake, and I really like that. It's cool just to see all of his different legacy robes and spread across the sets, and you can fill it in and have him go along with Kai and Zane. However, it is kind of weird, though, that it doesn't include the gold armor that Kai and Zane both have. Then we have Scoop, and I really like this minifigure, or I guess robot. He uses some really cool, interesting building techniques, including, like, this baby carrier upside down, as well as this little friend's, little guy binocular thing on the back. That looks really cool. And at last, we have Sensei Wu's dog. Woof, woof! This is a reference to, of course, Wu's Battle Dragon. And again, it's pretty cool to get a husky in the set. Now, the gardens is separated into a ton of different levels, so we'll take them apart now. So, here's the ground floor for Ninjago City Gardens. This thing is so beautiful. They use the same technique as they did in Ninjago City and Ninjago City Docks with the water, where they use black on the bottom and then use green, more green tiles on the outside to sort of give it that layered look. First, we'll start at this beautiful tree. Now, this is only the bottom of the tree, so don't get worried about why there's just weird flats and just poles sticking out of it. But at the very bottom, there's a little bench, which I really like that bench right there because it almost looks like it is carved from the tree. On each side, there's some roots growing over there, and I love how some leaves are blocking it. They also use this parts pack from the LEGO Ninjago Tournament of Elements set throughout the set, so you'll see a lot of usages of those. There's also this nice little piece that wraps around the entire tree to look like vines, which looks really pretty. They also have one of those superhero pieces right there to give it that extra little branch. There's also a little bird's nest up there using a lifesaver ring as well as that bird, which is just adorable. And then continuing down, you can also see just some more roots and stuff. I also love the sidewalk because they use a lot of these minifigure standards, some tiles. It looks very realistic, as well as a little table with some soy sauce on it. Continuing over to the right side, you can see some that detailing I was talking about on the ground level with the green and the black. There's also a pink frog and then some more of those jade blade pieces, which I really like. This beam is built up really coolly. I love the way it's built. You also have the bottom of Ronin's Pawn Shop, which has some really cool details in it, such as this little Easter egg thing, which is an actual
sticker which says Easter Egg in Ninjago language with a little ninja with bunny ears on it, as well as a green little tile, which I think is a reference to the City of Sticks, because in the City of Sticks, Ronan had a little table, and under that table, you could flip it up, and it revealed a green motherboard, and that motherboard only came in that set, as well as, like, an Ultra Agent set, so I think this is a reference to that. Can't be too sure, though. You also have some guests, I think those are supposed to be clothes, because that's how they built them up in the little shop in Ninjago City, a little statuette, as well as some jade blades, and then some stairs going up. They use a lot of these ingot pieces, which look really nice. Continuing over, you can just sort of see the beautifulness of the water. That's so elegant. I was also able to match up all of the Lego logos everywhere, just because I thought it would be some nice. It was very calming to do. There's also this beautiful little bush right here, as well as a hat, which is the same hat that Tito uses, but in gray, to represent a rock, which looks great. There's also some nice little, this little bonsai tree, I like to think of it as, with some nice little pine needles. There's also these little lights at the side, I think they are, and those just look so elegant. This whole little area is just so calming to build. And speaking of calming, you have this little side part. Now, this is technically not connected to the actual build itself. You build this last, but I really like it. It's Zane's little memorial scene, as well as this little gazebo, which I really like. One other thing I forgot to mention is that there's these little rocks throughout the entire build, which look really nice. You have some nice little lily pads on each side, which I think are the perfect way to build those. I think that's the best that they've come up with yet. There's also these really cool bridges, which they connect on the diagonal, and you can just see all the detail on this thing. There's so much greens and dark blues and blacks for the water. It's just beautiful. There's also some little piping in the each side under these, which really make it feel like it's part of Ninjago City. You have some more bushes, and I love the way they're able to get this little island so rounded off. It looks so realistic. I also love the top of this gazebo area with some more of these, like, Technic pieces with some megaphones, and there's some really interesting part usage there. There's also some really good little stones with some minifigure heads, and then, of course, the statue of Zane, which looks just so good. Let me see if I can get a good look at him. There you are. That looks great. I also love how they have the little poles. Now, Zane, personally, I have a problem with because he's missing his half mask. He doesn't have the right armor, but that's not really a fault of this little set. That's more of just a fault of that minifigure. But this is such a beautiful little area. Now, the last section I haven't really gotten to is this little area under the soup kitchen, which has some nice piping, some stairs, as well as this really cool Technic beam with some water coming out of it, which uses that superhero blast. This is so pretty. Now, let's add on the next couple of buildings. So, here is the first shop we'll take a look at, which is Ronan's Pawn Shop. So, Ronan looks really good in here, and there's a lot of room in this area, which is perfect for, you know, playing with someone with the set. I know a lot of people weren't really going to do that, but I actually intend to play with it with my little sister, because she is just watching Ninjago. You have some nice little lanterns on each side, which are connected with some party hats. You got some cool Dragon Blade pieces. The side has one of those nice little Ninjago gate pieces, and then from the front, you can actually just sort of see, well, actually, I don't know if you can see, so I'll take it out of the little section. You can just sort of see how pretty this little building looks. They use sand green, which looks great, a sticker on the side, as well as this really cool build for the side of the wall. To get it at this angled look, they use some of these hinge pieces, and they get it at this really nice angle. There's also another sticker with some more beams holding up that little awning. I love the inside of it. There's so many details, so I'm going to try and keep it brief. But you got a map of Ninjago, just like in the back of the Sword of Sanctuary. There's a ladder up here. A little head with a mustache right here, which is a reference to the original City of Sticks. A trident back here. You also have on this little shelf, let me see if you can get it through there, the Blade Cup, as well as one of these, like, weighing things. I don't really know what you'd call them, but, like, they weigh stuff, and I really like that, as well as these, which hold Ninjago trading cards. It is Spitta and Cruncher, or whatever his name, Whiplash. And when connecting Ronan's Pawn Shop to the actual build, it just fits over really nicely. 1 second, it's kind of hard because I'm doing it one-handedly, but it fits right over those ingots, and the insides match up with that little bit of gray stonework, so actually, the whole floor is filled in. You also can see that there's a trapdoor inside, which when you lift up, reveals the stairs to get down to his little bunker area.
Next up, we have what I like to call the soup kitchen. So this thing looks really nice. These a lot of really cool browns and whites, and I think they work really well together. You got a sticker right here. This awning uses a book piece, which is a really interesting part usage, but I'm not actually that big of a fan of it because all I really see is a book. Over here, you have some nice book covers, some like a pot and a little bowl, as well as a little menu for what you can order here. There's also a really cool TV antenna, and then these awnings are used clipped on with a riot shield, and they look really nice, as well as this little light. You can open both doors from the inside, from the outside, which are really nice, but actually I don't like them because when you need to get a minifigure in here while displaying it, they're really hard to shut. But yeah, now on the inside you can also see that there's this little shelf full of different like little knickknacks, as well as a sink. On this side, you just have that pot and that little bowl. On this side, it's pretty hard to get a good look at this. You can just sort of see some knickknacks on the wall. Let me lift the camera up. Where you can just sort of see the little knickknacks on the wall, and there's a lot of room to display a minifigure. And putting it on the spot, all it does is just cover those little pipes. And it also just looks really nice with that little awning out on the water. I really like that a lot. Now this shop goes above Ronin's Pawn Shop, which looks really nice. They use this nice little awning with the same technique that they used with the original Ninjago City for most of the roofs. You can just sort of see a teacup, as well as the interior of this one, which has some really nice artwork on it, as well as a little statue. There's also a little teacup in there, as well as a teapot. Over here you have a door to get from Ronin's Ladder in his pawn shop upwards. You have some nice little detailing from the outside. I love the little grates at the side, or maybe those are vents, as well as this little conducting or this like pipe work, which they use a paint powder's piece as well as a little syringe. Over to the side you also have this really beautiful window. I love the way that's done. You can also just sort of see the inside of this has just a little pot with a flower with a plant growing out of it, as well as the space for you to climb through the ladder up to this area. Which, when being connected to Ronin's Pawn Shop, fits on really nicely and a lot easier than a lot of the other buildings in the set. Of course, I'm actually struggling with it. But you can see that you just climb right through that ladder down into this space. That's now really here cool. Is the last building on the ground floor of the first level of Ninjago City Gardens. So this is actually the only building, or one of the only buildings in this entire set that you can't access through a doorway or a ladder or anything like that. There's no way to get in or out of this thing, so it makes it sort of feel unrealistic, but at the same time I really like the design of it. So on this you have a little banner that says Ninjago with a little ninja on it. So I originally thought this was going to be a dojo because you had her in the set, but nope, it's just a fan that really is into Ninjago. You have some beautiful windows, and I love again the building of just this entire set. Over here, you have some very beautiful windows using those elf pieces, as well as a flower pot. They also have this, which uses some really good part usage to get that nice shingled design. On this side, you also have some bluish green, as well as Sensei Wu's staff from the Golden Mech, which I really like. Taking my phone out of the holder, you can get a better look on the interior, where you have the fan's bed, a lava lamp. You also have the Keeper's Island set right here, the Catamaran Sea Battle, the Jungle Dragon, Kai's car on the floor from Rebooted. You also have a white slope, as well as a temple, which I think might be Unigami's Temple of Madness. You have this light, which is clipped on with a really cool part usage using the same piece as the mechanic's little saw. You also have over here a Ninjago City poster, which is the same poster that they gave away at Comic-Con, as well as a little a white statuette, which I think is meant to be one of those clocks. I still use my Cole and Lloyd ones, so that's pretty cool to see. They also have a really cool sticker for her bed, which when you remove it reveals a little thing, a weapon, and I really dislike that. I don't know why she has that, but I don't like it. But I do, however, love the little curtains on the side of her bed. This building I do have a problem with when connecting it on, and that is just because there's this just giant empty hole, so she could fall straight into the soup kitchen. Not a big fan of that, but besides that, it looks really good sitting there. I really like that. Now, one thing to mention before we put on this entire next floor, there's a little mini model of Jay's lightning jet that hangs from Chen's noodle shop, which just sort of hangs in the fan's apartment. I really like that little detail.
So here is the next floor all put on, and I really like it. So it is a little bit more challenging to put on than the other floors, but I still really like it. There's a ton of different references, but first we'll look at the buildings. So first, right here, you have the Master Chen minifigure, which we've already taken a look at, as well as a little sticker sign. The entrance looks really nice. I love the red and the gold and the dark blue, as well as the roof, which uses Lego hot dogs in black. Also on the side, they use a silver cup for the venting, which I really like. Moving over to, sorry that the camera's a little shaky, you have a little sticker, which I think is advertising a Puffy Pot sticker, maybe. There's also a little trash can, as well as an air vent, which I really like that. Then moving forward, you can see the inside of the sushi restaurant. You can see that there is some nice little stickers right here to indicate what you can buy at the sushi shop. A little light, as well as a little statuette. You can also see over here a little table which can sit too, as well as a sticker with some Anacon dry symboling. I really like that. Also, this side part, this little kitchen area, which you can see just has a little pan and a stove, can unclip and you can swing it out, which is really cool to be able to put a minifigure much easierly in that. I don't really know how to say that. Also on the back, there's some really nice little part usage with these like skis from Arctic, as well as this little flower bed, as well as this little roof. You can also see just how pretty that little window looks. Moving out forward to the ice cream shop, the back side of it has a little spilled ice cream cone, which uses a little heart, which looks really nice, as well as this cool little walkway, which uses this arrow right here. I really like that. There's also this little air conditioning vent, which is a lot bigger, which makes sense because it is a ice cream shop. There's also a door right here, as well as some nice roofing here with some game controllers. Now, they use a ton of different roof styles in this, but this has got to be one of my least favorites, only because I only see game controllers. So, not one of my favorites. Moving along the side, you can sort of see more of Chen's window in the back, as well as the side of the building. And then you can see the front, which I really like. It's got this Ice Cream Planet logo on this Mario face, which I'm pretty sure was used for Shy Guy, which I really like that, as well as it says Ice Planet, which is an original Lego theme. They also use butcher's knives for the roof, which I really like that part usage, and I think has got to be one of the best usages for roofs in this set. You can also see there's a little sticker right here for a little penguin with this visor on. I don't know what that says, but there's this door that can open. It says open on that sign, as well as this really cute little window, which I really like. You can also see some of the logos on this side have like this little Sensei Wu build. I really like the look of that. There's like a construction company, the Prime Empire logo, of course, which I really like that, with some game controllers, the Time Twins logo. I love the Time Twins after getting the Dawn of Iron Doom. There's also this little toy logo. There's also the stairway before going into the ice cream shop. You can see it says museum right there, as well as a little stairway with a railing which you can lead up to the museum. Now getting into the ice cream shop, you can see that there's a lot of really cute little details. Oops, just almost forgot to clip down that piece. But on the inside, you can sort of see that there's this little menu for what you can buy, which I really like that. Let's see if it will focus, as well as a little ice cream cone or some ice cream. Then you, on this side, have some nice little mugs, the Dots pineapple pencil holder, a little bit of ice cream, as well as a little glass. There's also a little stand to put hay to serve the ice cream, as well as some cones. Now those cones are stacked up, so I'll turn it so you guys can see it. Right there, which looks really nice. I like this ice cream shop a lot. There's also some vents there to get it on. There's some really good building techniques used on this as well. Now moving onward, you can see that there's a little bit of a railing right there next to Chen's noodle shop, as well as this ginormous tree, which looks so nice. It also has a Ninjago 10-year logo printed right on it. Now the tree sadly can move a lot when, you know, turning this thing, but it's easy again though to get it lined up. There's also this really cool build which uses some Prime Empire game holder, game shoulder armor, as well as some skeleton, black skeleton stuff. You have an ad for the shrimp, the crab shack from the first set, as well as a Znap logo. You also have this, which says Bilobo, as well as the M-tron logo. You have the Rock Raiders logo, as well as their logo, and then Rock Raiders. I don't like the use of these lanterns though, because first off, they have like these train hubcaps, so like they sort of move up and down and they don't really clip in, and they're blue for some reason, when in the first set they were bright neon orange, so it doesn't really click in with Ninjago City that well. There's also this sign that says aquarium, which is a really cool reference to season 3. There's also some peppers, and then a Lego Clickets. Yeah, I think that's what it is. Clickets logo over here. There's also this trash can, as well as this table, as well as the air vent. I think I already pointed that out. But one thing I'm mad about with the table is that they could have put in something to do with Zane missing. Like, they could have had that poster. Or if they just sort of rearranged the poster with that, they could have changed that into the Zane. I feel like that could have been a really cool detail, and they sort of missed out on it. But yeah, I really like this floor. Definitely one of the best floors. Now, the next floor consists of the museum as well as the fans' apartment. I really like the outside exterior of the museum, which uses this nice roller coaster piece, as well as one of those leaf pieces in gold combined with a Quidditch ring, which looks really nice. You also have some very beautiful windows right here using turquoise with dark red, which I really like. There's a crab on the side, as well as this really cool neon sign which says Dragon's Grill. I also love, again, this window. It looks so good. Now, moving on to the other side, you can see there's some gunmetal gray, like, step ladders or whatever, as well as a little post where you can put a minifigure looking out, you know, to look out at stuff. I love her little apartment, too. I forgot her name already, but it's her. You can see that they use this troll's skirt piece here for a flower bed, which looks really nice, and then all of this is built straight on, and they attach it, you know, using snot. They use this really cool little window area here, which I love the design of this little gate here. That is so perfect, and it matches just perfectly with this knit piece from the original Ninjago City, or Ninjago movie sets. Both of these are actually clipped on at the very end, which is pretty funny to think to me. You also have a door which opens out, as well as some nice pots. Moving on to the back, you can see there's another one of those really cool flower holders, a little telescope which uses the Friends robot piece, I don't really know what that guy is called, as well as some really cool railings with some nice black handcuffs, which of course you get in extras of. I'm thinking about plucking these right off the city and giving them to my ninja in Kryptarian prison to represent Vengestone handcuffs. You can also see a display in the museum of the Destiny's Bounty, which looks so good. I love that design of the Destiny's Bounty. There's also on this side a sign for Mega Monster Amusement Park, which is super cool, and I really like that detailing. There's also, moving on to the side, another sticker for the Ninjago City Museum that just says Museum in Ninjago City language, of course, as well as a little compass on the door. When you open it, you can get inside, as well as another one of those logos, which looks really cool. Now, going into the fans' apartment, you can just see that there is some really cool detailing, including Gale Gossip on the TV, which makes me sort of wish that this was Harumi's apartment, and we could have gotten Kid Harumi, and not this just random lady. There's also this really cool light up top, going over what appears to be a bonsai tree, as well as her bed. You can see the door, and on the other side, you have a little umbrella and a little holder, or a Technic pin, as well as a painting of Ninjago City Gardens itself. That is so cute. She also has the Dots pencil pot holder, which is really cool. Now, moving on to the museum, you can just sort of see the interior of it is really cramped. Like, and when I say really cramped, I mean really cramped. There you go. So moving on to the gift shop, which is where we'll start, because that is the entrance to the museum, you can see that there is a little holder for postcards, which that's what I think it is. They use a lot of different cool tiles, as well as a mini build of the Temple of Erijutsu, which is just built phenomenally. A little cash register with a green thing on it. Don't know what that green thing is, as well as a little turnable, which is really cool. Moving on, sorry, I use headphones to film, and they keep getting stuck on the branches of the tree. You have some nice stickers to represent some posters, as well as what appears to be a replica of the Realm Crystal, which I really like, a security camera on one side, as well as some more security cameras on the other side, the Destiny's Bounty, as well as a Serpentine Staff. They have the portrait from Hands of Time, which I really like that sticker piece, and a really cool reference is that you can remove both of these panels. They both are connected only by one stud. And it almost looks like the mechanic drilled a hole using his ginormous saw right through to steal stuff from the museum, which is a really cool little Easter egg. Turning the whole build around, you can see that there's some nice lights leading on the portrait of Sensei Yang, which is so nice that we finally got it, as well as this really cool build with a treasure chest and a glass piece to represent the Yin Blade. You can also see over here you have a portrait of Rei and Maya, which is super cute, as well as a nice little shelf with a portrait with a statuette, as well as another one of those compass prints. Moving on, you can also see on this side that there is a sticker. Let's see if it will show of the Great Devourer, as well as a section of Ninjago. Yeah, this has got to be one of my favorite floors. Just like the other one, this floor is packed with so many references to the Ninjago TV show. But I think this one's got to be one of the best because of the amazing architecture and the pieces that they chose to use. Now, here is the next floor of the city, which is where you're supposed to clip this little hoverboard thing, which is why they included that little pole. Don't like it, so I'm going to take it off. You can see that there's some really cool, like, roofing on the side, as well as these cool little bars. Again, using that Ninjago texturing. We haven't gotten a purple building yet in Ninjago City, any of the expansions, so it looks really nice to have one, finally. As well as I love the shutters matching up with Lloyd's apartment from the first set. There's also a little safe back here with a turquoise slope, which I very much don't know what the heck that is. And I feel like it's missed opportunity because whatever it is, it's got to be some reference that I don't even understand. And I'm a huge Lego nerd. So if I don't understand it, I'm going to guess a lot of people don't understand it either. And that could have been the perfect opportunity to include the Prime Empire motherboard. Also inside, there's a little tea time table, which I really like the build of that. That's so good. As well as this really cool roof using treasure chests of all things to display that nice shingled roof look. There's so many different roof builds in the set, it's just crazy. Now you can flip most of them up and reveal a little helmet and a roller skate. And with that, and then the purple of the set, it's made you to think that it's a reference to Camille, which I think is a really nice reference. However, it is kind of funny though that we don't get Camille, even though she is the last elemental master that we need. There's also a little flower, as well as this little area, which I really like, and then some nice roof, nice tiles. The next floor is the Ninja's gaming apartment, or just like the Ninja's hangout space. This has honestly got to be one of my favorite parts of the entire city, for one little thing alone, which I'll take a look at the very end, because it is one of my favorite parts. So you have this little, they have these little railings, which use brick head glasses, which I really like, as well as this really cool build of a shrimp, which uses some of those Mario little Goomba feet. There's also this telescope right here, which has only one little eye lens, as well as some gears, which uses the faucet piece, which is really cool. Moving inside, you have the portrait of the ninja, which does that confirm that there's going to be a Legacy 2 Zane? I think it does, because that is an exclusive print for his torso, so I'm going to guess that that is him, or it's just his his Season 5 torso. I don't know which one it is, but let's hope it is the Tournament of Elements Zane. Also on the side, you have Prime Empire being played on the TV, which is a reference to Prime Empire, of course, as well as Season 13. And then they use a little tile down there to represent the ornate design of the TV stand. I love the little swivelly chair, which is some really cool part usages, as well as this hat on this coat stand. This is definitely the best part. And I was going to save this for the end, but I think I'll just show you guys now. It's this little game arcade box, which has some ninja on each side, which I really like that. And you just press down, and Kai jumps. That's a print in the middle, as it is a print in the middle, which is so cool, as well as a Great Devourer logo, or what's meant to be the Great Devourer. I don't think it is, but it's really cool. I love that design. It's such clever usages of those pieces. Now, on the other side of it, you can sort of see that there's a Space Police poster, which is really cool to see because Space Police reminds me a lot of Clutch Powers, which I really like. Now, you can take that out and put in other posters, which we'll see later in the set. They also use some more of those painter palette pieces for the lights. You also have this little ladder, which you can turn this gear, and the ladder comes falling down, which is such, again, so clever. It's like, how did I never think to use that before? So yeah, this is a really cool little building, and let's get into the next floor. The next floor has some more of those really nice gate pieces, which come to like such a good design. They also use some of these Nexonite pieces, which I absolutely love. There's also this cool little roof detailing, which they get at this nice little, like, little angle, which looks really good. And then you can just sort of see more into that. So the inside of it actually includes our very last minifigure, which we've already taken a look at, which is Legacy J, which is such a surprise to this set. There's also some extra movie posters, which you can put in that slot, including this one, which is a reference to Ultra Agents 2, which I really like that. I don't know what it says, but I like it. Then the other one has a reference to actually not Johnny Thunder, but to the minifigure of Johnny Thunder that came in the CMF series last year, or 20, or 19, or whatever. I can't really remember. But I really like the design of that. That's super cool. But yeah, I like this floor a lot, or this little building.
Fee-fi-fo-fum, here comes the next one. Sorry. I'm going a little crazy. This is the biggest set I've ever reviewed. This one's super cool, because you can sort of see these really nice tiling inside of these panels, which look like they're almost hollow. On the inside, you have a little ninja control center, where you have a little sticker of Pythor and Cryptor with a little board, as well as a little control seat for the ninja to sit. I really like the design of that. And here's the last floor, which just adds some nice translucent pink pieces from Nexonites, actually, on the very top. And then moving all the way up, you have some more antennas, which I really like the design of that. But yeah, this tower is such a good-looking design. I love it so much. And I think it might just have to do, though, with how much I love the Lego Nexonite piece that they use. And then the last thing we have to put on is the very top to the museum. This thing is so pretty. I love the just glass that they have. And while I was building this, I actually thought to myself that if I was designing the museum, what I would do differently would be that I would somehow include, a small statue of the Grundle. And as I was saying that, I realized that they actually put in a little statuette of not the Grundle, but a mini dragon. But that is the Grundle to me. To me, it's like that that's them knowing that there should be the skeleton in it, so they put it in. Now, I could easily take off those wings and call it the Grundle, and I would be happy, which is probably what I'll do. You also have some just really cool part usage just all around for this thing, including this beautiful cherry blossom tree, which I love very much. Honestly, this has got to be one of my favorite LEGO sets of all time, if not my favorite. There's so many details to Ninjago, as well as just so much good part usage. I can't stress how much I love the different pieces that they use all over this thing. It's so vibrant compared to the other one, and so much prettier. I love the design of the waterways at the bottom, how they flow through the entire building, and all of the minifigures are a lot more show accurate and more, like, you know, like they're more geared towards the show. However, this wasn't the first Ninjago City expansion, which is why I think Ninjago City has got to be one of still my favorite. I'm not sure, maybe over time Ninjago City Gardens will overtake Ninjago City, but the freshness of the first one has got to be what's holding this in. For $300, I cannot stress enough how much I love this thing. It's so beautiful, it's so big, it's so complex. It's like a puzzle just waiting to be solved, and I love it for that. This has got to be one of the best LEGO sets ever. And that wraps up the biggest LEGO set that I own's review. This has got to be one of my favorites, and I can't believe that I was able to review it. Thank you guys all so much for watching, and have a great day. Thank you so much. Bye.